Warning, the following program contains crude language, portrayals of graphic violence, alcohol use, smoking, and strong opinions on soft topics such as sex, race, religion, money, love, war, and world politics. Viewer discretion is advised.
What's up, everybody? My name's Emerson Thor. This is the Monday Medicine. I got a little guitar here, about to play a little song from my man, KP. What's up, brother?
What's up?
Hey! Behind the scenes, we have Sweetie. What's up, brother?
Oh,
I'm good.
You're looking good, buddy.
You're looking always great. Looking good.
Oh, shit. Boy, here we go. Here we go.
Stop.
Yeah. And to the left of him, it's Cheeks.
What up, Cheeks? How you doing, brother?
Not bad, not bad.
Not bad at all?
Not bad
all right.
At all.
Very nice.
Good, good, good.
Just talk right into that mic.
Yes, you will. Ah. Gently playing you a song here.
Out of tune.
Medicine.
Kevin! Why weren't you at work? Kevin.
KP.
Yes, sir.
We went to see you on Saturday.
I heard.
Yes, sir.
I saw the picture.
Oh, boy. We did post a little selfie, if you will, which is something you shouldn't do if you're our age, but we did it anyway for the hell of it, for the show. And you were not there.
What time did you guys go in?
We went in about noon.
Why do you care?
It's not like you were there.
I was there. I was there briefly.
Well, here's a picture of me and Emerson. Oh, that's a horrible picture.
That's a horrible show.
It's a horrible but life.
There is absolutely nobody in the background there. Nobody cooking us food.
No, we didn't have to wait too long because at that point it was pretty slow. You would have probably had an easy day.
Probably.
But you didn't.
I did
you
have
had
an
two
easy
days.
I did have two. I had one day that turned into two.
There we are.
And I usually I'm there in between those two beautiful men. You see their backs.
They did mention and appreciate the absence of you.
Good. Good. Sometimes they need a little KP out of their life.
Little KP.
Little KP out of your life.
Wow. A lot of KP out of your wife. That's how we do it on the Monday Medicine here, folks. Plenty to talk about on our boring web show. But I'll tell you what we're going to do first. I called the radio station today.
Did you?
Well, it appears we had a shooting at the Gates Pub. Did you hear about that, everybody?
Yeah, I woke up to it.
Did you? You were sleeping in that kitchen?
No, actually, on my way home that day, someone had texted me after I got sent home from work.
Yeah, oh, there you go.
Someone had texted me and said, did you hear about the pub? And I said, I did not. And then the details were explained briefly.
That they were. And yeah, there was a shooting. Unfortunate. But I guess the Gates Pub Bar, fatal shooting happened over the week. They say the news said it was three times over its limit when the shooting happened.
What was the occupancy?
Yes, their occupancy is 99. So they're saying they had 300 people in that jammy.
Really?
What? That's what they're saying. Wow. What's the most people you've ever seen in there, do you think, when it was even packed?
Like some of those nights when Biz would do, like, have the DJ shit?
Yeah, or say, like, after Biz's funeral.
Yeah, yeah.
Where, how many? Was it 300? I don't think it was 300.
I saw maybe 125, 150, maybe.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, 300 people? That's a lot of people in that place. I used to work there.
I did, too.
I called the Kimberly and Beck Show because they were talking about the topic. And,
which they love to do.
Sure they do.
They love slamming the pub.
They love slamming the public.
Yes.
But I still like Kimberly and Beck. I still don't think they should have been fired the last time. Whatever. I'm not saying I listen to them, but I like the freedom of speech, and I don't think anybody should be fired or canceled for what they say. If it's their opinion, who cares? Just stop listening.
True.
So whatever, they were going on and on, and there was a bunch of callers, you know, some people saying that the whole place is a front for a huge cocaine operation.
Blah, blah, blah.
Some people, you know, obviously our friend Susie called up and said, you know, she bartends there. She wasn't there that night. She was camping. And she said, you know, basically what everybody that has ever been there or worked there knows. Mike, Mark, Brian, when he was around, you know, they treated you like family.
Sure.
You know, it was a nice place. Now, obviously, the clientele changed over the last couple years. A couple bars downtown closed, so they're going somewhere closer to their neighborhood. I guess I can't blame them. For the most part, you know, they get over pretty well. It's a good place. You could go there as a... you know, a large white guy, and we are. And you can have a couple drinks, and there's usually no problems. There was a stabbing a couple years ago, and then they were going on and on about, you know, the problems with the bar, and the there was, a bunch of people, you know, doing drugs and being unruly. But doesn't that happen... pretty much at
every single bar I've ever been to, there's someone doing drugs. There's someone that's been overserved or someone that can't handle their alcohol. It happens every fucking bar you go to.
I mean, every bar. You can go into a country club, you know, late on a Friday and find like a dusting of coke on the fucking sink.
Sure.
Whatever, you know, the sink counter. I don't think it's exclusive to the Gates Pub, but, you know, the Marcassini, Gatestown, what is he, the rep or the town board?
Councilman, or is that what he is?
Gatestown Supervisor, Marcassini. I don't want to not do our research for this topic. We got scolded 2 weeks ago for that, or last week.
He's running for Congress.
Who is, Assini?
Yes.
Nice.
Great. Actually, I don't even dislike the guy, but that means he's going to be a piece of shit.
He's young.
Yep.
Well, that means he should have a long life of lying to the public out of him if he's going to Congress. I don't think you can do it at the town level so much because people know you, they see you, you're friends with a lot of people that are around, and that's how it is. But when you get to that state level, I think there's a lot more wiggle room to lie and be bribed and be paid by lobbyists.
I'm sure it still happens even on the local level, like very even towns.
Sure. We would have Google Fiber if, you know, like, I think it was Maggie Brooks and a couple of her people didn't get paid off by Time Warner to say, oh, we're not interested in Google Fiber. Do you know how happy I would be if we had Google Fiber? Have you ever seen some of those amazing internet speeds?
No.
Oh, my God. It's just ridiculous. Every time somebody gets Google Fiber, you're just so jealous of that town. You know, not that they're not collecting all your data and selling it to third parties as advertising and then trading that to the government. But even Time Warner does that, too. So you're stuck with a slow transfer of your data. Unfortunate. But it looks like they're going to have a town hall meeting or whatever. But I don't know. I honestly think they're going to close the place down.
You think so?
Yeah. You have a shooting. One guy dead.
Not just a shooting, dude. I mean, this guy lit the place up, dude.
Well, it was a murder. I think from what I heard, he put the gun right to the guy's head and pulled the trigger.
Which is fucking crazy.
Well, it is crazy, and it's uncalled for, and I don't believe that it was a legal gun owner. But, you know, one person shot.
Wasn't the guy on parole for firearms and drug possession?
He was on parole. He was an early release. But I'll tell you this. Let's say he's on parole, or he's not on parole. He's in jail and he serves his full sentence, right? And then he gets out. Do you think anything's going to change? Do you think the extra time is going to soften him as a criminal?
Oh, he's never getting out, dude. This guy, he's going to get life.
No, but I'm saying even if he, you know, served his whole time, do you think after that and he's not on parole, that would cause him to not shoot somebody?
When he's 60 years old and he finally gets out?
I mean, maybe.
If he gets out?
But
I mean, that was pretty malicious, dude. One dead, six injured. It was the fucking Wild West up in there.
I think the whole situation has there's a lot of different problems, a lot of different angles, a lot of things that need reform. Obviously, the parole, the fact that
I'm sure he wasn't supposed to be out at a bar.
I'm sure he wasn't supposed to have a gun.
Yeah.
He's not charged with first-degree murder. It's second-degree.
Second, yeah.
It's not first.
Because first is premeditated, right?
300 people. If you shot a gun in that place, it's going to go through at least 3 or 4 people, right? They got it packed in there.
Yeah, they would have to be. Yeah, it would have to be shoulder to shoulder. So, I don't know. But, so what are we looking at? We're looking at the parole. We're looking at, there was just some story in Texas about some guys broke into a house and then they were armed. So they murdered is the unlawful killing, but they killed the intruders because they were armed and ready for it.
What's this guy's name?
This guy's name is David Allgood. Age 31 is charged in connection with the shooting. It says here on WHEC Channel 10's website that Monday afternoon, the Gates Pub remains closed. Shut down, and the town supervisor says security video from inside the bar that night shows there were 3 times more people inside than the law allowed. I don't think that had anything to do with the shooting. If that guy was in there, you know, it makes it sound like he was the specific target. So if that guy was in there, he would have been shot.
Yeah, but was it an issue that happened in the bar? Was it something that happened before? This dude just pulled out a piece and just started firing. Was there an argument before, or did he just walk up, pull out a gun, and just start shooting?
Well, he's saying that it was packed in violation of the town ordinance. He said only 50 are allowed in the building under town law, so there were 3 times the number. But I heard Susie say on the news today that there are 99 people allowed in there because they have both sides.
Yes.
Same as the infield. That place was allowed 99.
I think so.
So
yeah.
I think due to the square footage, Marcassini was incorrect.
Sure.
You know? So they were slightly over the limit or whatever. I don't know. I don't know. I think that if you close this bar, it's going to happen somewhere else. You know, I hate to see Mike lose his bar.
Sure.
That sucks. This
guy's lost enough.
Yeah, he's lost a lot. He's lost his son, untimely death of his son, Brian.
Lost his wife, lost his brother.
Yeah, there's been a lot of people that have bit the dust. And I guess that happens when you're going on late in life, but you never want it to be, you know, your kid. You're supposed to go first.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because the kid should suffer. That's how I feel. Shouldn't be the parent. But anyway, so I don't know. There's the town board. They said they've given an opportunity, been given an opportunity to rectify the situation. But it didn't matter. It was so horrific that he decided to shut the bar down. So as you've seen on the news, they've got the papers on the window.
Yeah, and, no occupancy.
Right.
Blah, blah, blah.
And there's also the little, you know, memorial set up to the guy that did die.
Yep.
Actually, what was his name before we're completely strung up here? I don't know. Somebody
I think his name is Ricky Davis.
What the hell was his street name, though?
I think Jones, it was like... wasn't it?
No.
Ricky C. Jones.
Ricky C. Jones.
But he had another name. I can't remember what it was. It was like...
Either way.
I can't even think about it.
I know some people that knew him, said he was a good father, cared about his kids a lot, whatever. I'm, you don't ever wish nobody dead, dude. I mean, it's not, especially like that. Somebody just walks up and just shoots you.
And I really never hear anybody going, yeah, he sucked. Glad he's gone,
no
matter who it is.
Exactly.
They're always finding somebody that really cared about the guy. But I was listening to Kimberly and Beck, and apparently he had been shot multiple times on one occasion before. So they were kind of questioning if, his niece, I think, if, you know, he was involved in anything. And she was like, oh, I'm not here to talk about that. I'm just here to tell you he was a great guy and whatever. And then I got on and said, you know, Mike's a great guy. They treat you like family. They're like, oh, how long did you work there? Or what made you leave? And I was like, well, it was 15 years ago. So I, you know, when I worked there, so it was... obviously, just nobody's gonna.
You just moved on to
to better things, and then they hung up on me.
Really?
Yeah, and I talked for about another 35 seconds before I realized I was disconnected. And that's what happens when you're on a stupid cell phone.
Because listen, they don't want Kimber. They don't want someone to call up and go, "Hey, it was a decent place. The owner's a pretty good guy."
Well,
we know Mike. Mike could give you the shirt off his back, dude.
Gonna have a fun time editing this out.
I don't think it was making it. I made a call.
There you go. Yeah, so it was, you know, one of those places where everybody knew the people. Crowd switched at night,
which is most bars.
Yeah, sure, they
most
got their
bars.
Regulars, and people knew the guy. Apparently, he was a good dude. It was a shooting. I'm sure there'd be a bunch of people that say it was, because of the race of the people, because of the time of the incident. Just go home. Just go home. If you're staying out past 12 or 1 o'clock, there's bound to be nothing great that's going to happen to you.
Never had nothing ever good happened to me after midnight.
No.
You guys know that.
Yes. Yes. Pulling up in the cop car back to the studio like, hey, I'm back. Help me out of the car.
Yep.
Oh, my God. You are a massive freak to have to help under your own weight. But anyways, it looks like it's going down. And I remember, you know, that was when it was half the size. That was one of the places we first drank out here. Yep. We'd go there with all the boys. It was around Christmas time. We played some Christmas in Hollis on the jukebox.
Sure did.
And I don't know. It was a good time.
Always was, dude. I mean, we always had a good time. I bounced there. You cooked there.
Sure. I actually even bartended there for a little bit. Yep. I was probably the only male bartender that they ever had, aside from the owners and, you know, the sons and that. But whatever. Made some great cash there. Oh,
sure.
So great.
Oh,
you get up there and shake your ass. I'll speed pour drinks. Oh, what a great life that was. Made so much money. Well, good luck, Mike.
I hope it doesn't get closed, but... it seems like they're pushing hard for it.
I'm sure they will. And he's going for Congress, so he's got to be tough on something.
Yep.
But speaking of closing down, Everest Institute.
Oh!
If you are sick of those annoying commercials, just like I am, the Everest Institute is no more. Basically, they said they ran out of money. What do you think of that?
How do they run out of money when they have so many people go there?
Spend too much on advertising.
I mean,
really?
I don't know. Everybody I know has got a goddamn lousy fucking 12-week certificate from that fucking place.
Yeah, and then everybody goes and they're like, oh, I got 40 credits from Everest Institute. And the next school you go to takes about 3.
Yeah. It's definitely, it's almost comparable to online schooling. Where you go, oh, 6-week course, you'll have a HVAC certificate. Yeah, how many places are going to take that and accept that?
Plus,
not Schmegs. I really wanted to bring in a whole stack of applications for you today. I just forgot.
Kevin, weren't you at work?
I was not at work. I did go to work.
We heard. You sat outside lazily having a cigarette with one shoe hanging out.
Actually, I did not.
Oh. And did she meet you in the parking lot?
Yes.
She doesn't look like a sprinter. Doesn't look like she jumped out the moment she saw you pull in.
I pulled into the parking lot. I saw Mitch walking in the door. I beeped the horn and waved at him like, I'll see you in a minute, buddy.
And then you finished your smoke.
I didn't have a smoke. I fucking put on a quick fucking splash of cologne.
Jesus. Cologne for what?
I don't know. Just because. That's what I do.
Lilacs?
I got out of the car and...
Schlitz?
What covers Jameson? I need to know.
Do you?
Yeah, you do.
Because let's talk about this, sweet tea. You can have
Black
all the,
and Milds
you can have all the jokes in the world, but you've also been reprimanded at work quite a few times.
Oh, yeah, I got in trouble.
You've been suspended more
than
once.
And then I quit drinking.
Dude, no, you didn't. You didn't quit drinking after that. You quit drinking because your girlfriend
did.
Would leave you if you didn't. So stop
it's
with
worse
the nonsense.
Than suspended.
Yeah.
Then it's back to being a slob. That's
being expulsion. Suspended on a couch by myself.
Expulsion right there, buddy.
That's a large suspension.
Oh, my God. That's a large couch. You fucking...
But so she met me in the parking lot. Said you were supposed to be here. I said, I know. And basically, I probably was supposed to be there at 7. I wasn't. She called me at about 7:15. I said, all righty, I'm on my way. I got up. I took a shower. I took a shit. I brushed my teeth. I got dressed. And I got there a few minutes after 8. And she said, well, if you thought you were going to have to be here at 8, it's 8:07. Take the rest of the day off, and we'll give you a call. And I was like, oh.
Not again.
Damn it. Tommy never did this to me. So later on that night, I received a phone call and said my bosses were a little disappointed in me and that I can also have Sunday off, and we'll see you next week for your regular scheduled hours. I hung up the phone. I said, okie dokie.
I feel like you didn't say okie dokie.
No, she actually said... We feel like you lied to us and you knew you had to be here at a certain time.
Well, they said the night before you were sitting at the bar saying something about chopping potatoes the next day and you'll be here promptly at 7.
I never said that. Never said 7 o'clock.
And you hung up the phone and grabbed the closest Shea Lounge you could find.
Shea Lounge?
Curled up with some Netflix and enjoyed your day off.
I feel like it was a bittersweet day off for him because he does like money.
Exactly, dude. I wasn't happy about the second day off. The first one, I was like, all right, I fucked up. I'll go home. I'll take the fucking smack on the fanny. I'll go home.
But the second day off.
The second day off, I'm like, I need that fucking cash. Yeah. Now I know what. Now.
They were in the wrong.
No, they.
It was
dude,
their
you're
fault.
You're an idiot. No, I was in the wrong.
Kevin! Why weren't you at work?
Oh, you poor bastard. Poor
so the second day off was, they, you know, where do they hit you when they want to prove a point?
Right in the pocket.
Right in the pocket.
Oh, Mr. Harvey taught me that.
And
they made me use vacation days.
Right? Yeah. Huh? Ooh, hurt you so much. Okay, sorry. I'm suspended? Kid called up his fucking dealer immediately.
And girlfriend.
Yes.
Yeah. Guess what I'm doing, honey?
I got a big bag of Coke.
Well, you know what else was in town, local news? Actually, before we skip it, local boy, John Jones.
John Bones Jones.
Dude, they are talking
What's
about...
What's going on with this guy?
look, Albuquerque. It was in New Mexico. And I guess they were... what does this say here? This is from Deadspin.
He said he got into a car accident with a pregnant woman.
Three-car crash.
Fled the scene.
Included fighter John Jones, and according to witnesses, John acted like a man who really didn't want to stick around. Witnesses told police that driver three, later identified as Jones, ran away, then came back, grabbed a handful of cash from the car, then shoved the cash into his pants and ran.
And when police came to the scene and searched his vehicle, they found a quantity of marijuana that I don't think they disclosed how much, but it was enough to, I'm assuming, charge him. He was just busted for doing coke before a fight.
Yes.
This guy's got some issues, dude. He's making so much money. He's one of the biggest figures in UFC. Come on, dude. Stop it. Just stop smoking blunts and sniffing fucking rails, dude.
Albuquerque Journal was told by police spokesman that they were seeking a felony charge because one of the drivers involved a pregnant woman in her 20s who had a broken arm because of the accident. Phone call. There it is. Light it up, boys. Yes, it is. Nah, pick up the phone. We missed it.
Did we miss it?
No.
God damn it. Call back.
We got to drop that farther down now.
Oh, my God. Or turn the annoying ringer on.
Yes.
Did you want Cheeks to do a redial?
No.
Oh.
Yeah, still call
no.
Back.
No, call back. Sorry, we missed it.
The numbers again are 585-300-4887.
Right across the screen. Call us. Tell us about our terrible, terrible guitar
there
playing.
Is.
There it is.
Punch it right through there, buddy. Oh, right, we want to listen to him take a phone call?
We love Cheeks. He does such a wonderful job back there. He's so awesome. Send it through.
Hey, what's up? You're on Under the Skin. Who's this?
Oh, this is Codename.
Codename! What's up, man?
Oh, what's up, brother?
Been a long time since you called. You hear about that UFC crash?
It has been a while, man. I can barely hear you guys, but let's talk about some violence.
Let's talk about some violence. What do you got for us?
Is it ever going to stop? Is it ever going to get any better?
No.
No. Actually,
two letters, an N and an O. No.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. I think somebody...
Not in our time.
I think somebody famous one time was quoted as saying, picture the future as a black boot stomping on a human face forever and ever and ever. And that's what we have. What do you think?
Well, I tell you what, I love cops, you know. I don't really feel like, you know, they've ever done me wrong. And I've been in a lot of legal predicaments in my lifetime. But never once have I ever gotten beaten up or killed, for that matter, you know?
Are you a white male?
I am a white male. I grew up in the city of Rochester here.
As did me and Emerson?
World. That's the thing. I've been all over the world. I've been to Okinawa, Japan. I got in trouble over there. I've been out in California, got in trouble out there. I got in trouble out in Mississippi, all for violence. Related things like fights and just general bar shit.
Are you an angry man, Codename? Or were you an angry man? Were you an angry drunk? How about that?
A wild, angry individual. Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
let me ask you this now. You said you've been in a bunch of altercations with the police, or at least where they, you know, times when they needed to be there. Were you ever undeserving of the cops being called, or were they kind of right and you could see that later?
Man, I tell you what, I was kind of glad they were there sometimes. There was one time on Main Street outside of Soho where a fight inside of the bar, I tried to throw somebody out of the window, and that didn't work. I was dragging bouncers around, and we went out to the street, and I was like, man, when is this going to end? I think this guy's going to have to die for this to end. And a Rochester cop placed his boot on my right knee, on the back side of my right knee. And
took you right down.
Buckled you like a... Nothing, just a ton of bricks hitting the ground.
Dude, I tell you what, I can't walk the same.
Really?
And then they slammed me into a wall, but I told them, I was like, man, look, I'm ex-military. This dude was attacking me. They ended up letting me go and picking him up off the sidewalk. But I even that instance, I can't say I was ever done wrong. And I complied. And it could have got worse because I could have been like, nah, fuck that dude attacked me. But I complied with what the cop told me to do, and then he ended up letting me go.
Sure.
I mean, if the cop's coming up on somebody that's basically mopping the floor and then the sidewalk with an individual, and he kicks you in the back of the knee, you know what? I don't know that that's the worst thing that could happen.
Man, he could have shot me. He could have stunned me.
You could have took a billy club over the back of the head.
Exactly. He could have done all kinds of different things, but that's what he chose to do to me, to break the fight up. Essentially, I mean, I was kind of like, man, I was like, when I really wondered, when was it going to end? Because I heard to the left of me, you know, this chick, I was fighting with a cigarette in my mouth. This chick said, you can't fight with a cigarette in your mouth.
Oh, that's against the rules, Cody.
They always want to tell you what to do.
That's against the rules.
And
no
another
smokes.
Another person chimed in and was like, oh, no, he's not trying to fight that nigga. He's trying to kill that nigga.
Oh, no.
And that's when I was like, oh, my God, this is never going to end. What am I going to have to do here? Because his boys weren't trying to step in.
Well, once you see your boy getting flattened, dude, you're not stepping in unless you're, you know, I mean, we would step in if that was one of our boys because that's just what we do and how we grew up. But
right.
It doesn't matter who's taking a whooping. If we all got to take a whooping to try to protect one of our friends, that's just what's going to happen. But those days
right.
are long gone for us. We're all old, fat,
yeah,
and out of shape, brother.
Stepping on the good, that's a, now, and then after that, I said, all right, man, I got to mellow out, lay off the booze and all that. I've run into the law here and there, just doing dumb shit with cars and fast cars
sure.
and going too fast. Not a single time did I ever get disrespectful to a cop and had a bad time. You know, if you got to understand, cops are smart people. They're fucking smarter than me. And if I'm doing 80 and a 30, I'm in the wrong.
Yeah.
You know, when he comes out, I got to pull over and, you know, give it up. You know, if I got a little bit of weed or whatever,
sure,
just give it to him. Just give up. You know what I mean? Just. It is what it is.
Most
10 times out of 9, they're going to let you go.
Exactly. Most of my run-ins with cops.
They're trying to catch the big time guys, and the
sure.
big time guys, they are the guys that are going to go down with a fight. Everybody's got something to hide. There's something that in every single story out there right now with this violence, somebody's hiding something. Something's
sure.
going on.
Now,
the cops are on the good side.
For the most
Don't
part,
fight
dude.
The cops.
There is dirty cops everywhere. You can't deny that fact.
No, I can't.
I mean, there's dirty cops that'll try to set you up or do whatever they can just to save their skin if they're in the wrong. Maybe they hit you one too many times or whatever they were doing. Most of my times
you know,
in run-ins with cops,
there's cops out there that will run right over your rights if you give them the chance to.
Absolutely.
Or a reason to. I mean, not like you said, 9 times out of 10. You know, they're not just happening upon you. Somebody called them because of something. You know, in your case,
exactly.
Maybe if you're going 80 in a 30, maybe you whipped right by them and didn't see them. That's just them being in the right place at the right time. Nobody's pulling you over doing a 30 in a 30 or even a 35 in a 30 for the most part.
Right, right.
But if they do, what are you gonna say? You have to comply. It's like
you have to comply.
You know, I mean, and I'll say this to even those people that are, you know, thinking of fighting the officer or whatever, or there's some bad cops. All right, there are some bad cops. Treat it like this. Treat it like if you treat it like all cops are going to kick the shit out of you and you just relax and relinquish, like, control of the situation to them, usually don't get the shit kicked out of you. Don't try to take off and run. Don't try to pull out a weapon. Don't try to tackle somebody. It is what it is.
Yeah, once the cops show up, you're done. There's, you know what I mean? Yeah. What are you going to do?
Yeah,
exactly. It is over. Once they show up on the scene, you no longer are in control, and you no longer... You might not even have been controlled before they showed up. If you were drinking and got into a fight, which I've done before on many occasions... It happens. You're not even in control then.
Very true.
You know, here's the funny thing. I understand it now in my lifetime. Okay, if the cops, if it hasn't happened in a long time, but if the if happens, I understand it as if the cops are here, the cops are here. That automatically kind of means I'm tied up for about a good hour. I'm detained.
Sure.
Somebody called them here. They have a reason to be here. Let them do their thing, and I'm sure everybody's going to walk away in different directions.
And you know what? Most times when you do give up, which I've done many a times, it does end very peacefully, and you usually get out of it fairly unscathed.
You might have a piece of paper that you have to
sure.
sign and walk away and think about, how could I have done this different?
Yep.
That's the worst of it on my part. You know, I know some people want to turn around and charge a cop and end up dead, and then their families go crazy.
Yeah.
Well, where is the whole, this is the, man, it all goes back to, like, school, and you got to, people have to respect authority. That's the thing that people do not respect.
But the lack of that the lack of respect and authority has been growing for many years, dude, that people don't respect cops anymore. They don't realize that cop could have just came from a murder before he showed up on your drunken scene where you beat the shit out of somebody.
Exactly.
You don't know what that guy had to do that day or what he's done in the last month or what kind of scenes or what he's had to deal with. I mean, it's crazy.
Oh, we got another call. Huh? Yep. I'll have to disable that, I guess.
But no, what do you? So this Baltimore thing, man, just another crazy fucking situation, right?
You know, and it's unwarranted. That's the thing. It's another unwarranted situation that it needs to be dealt with in a different way, so that none of these situations keep happening. That's the thing. It needs to be shut down professionally.
Well,
it needs to have some big game players come into the mix and say, all right, we're not going to fucking take this anymore.
Yep.
You need to respect authority. If a cop is showing up, there's a fucking problem. There's a reason. You know it, and they know it too, because they just got the call.
Sure.
That's the thing.
And most of the times, it is warranted. I'm sure there is some unwarranted people getting pulled over in the black communities or people getting harassed in the black communities. I'm sure that goes on. I'm not saying it doesn't. But, you know, if you start mouthing off to the cops because of whatever, if they pull you over and you don't really have a reason to be pulled over, you're probably going to get let go in the end because they're not going to find anything or they're not going to see that you've done anything.
Turn your dome light on, put your hands on the wheel, and just wait for them to come up to the car.
I'm telling you right now, cops are not looking to give out. I mean, yeah, you got your parking meter maids and whatever, your traffic enforcement cops. But for the vast majority of it, cops are not looking to give people tickets. Cops are not looking to pull you over because you got a taillight out or a headlight out, or for that matter, a clearance or a marker light out. They're not looking to pull you over for that.
No.
But if they do, all you have to do is simply comply. The worst you're going to wear, in all circumstances of a light being out and bullshit along those lines, I've walked away with a fix-it ticket.
Sure.
Meaning I fix it the next day, I show a cop the next day, he signs off on it, I send it in, and then bang, there's nothing else behind an extra of it. But when you just don't respect the authority of a police officer and the oath he's taken and what he puts his life on the line for, when you don't respect that anymore, that you are going to run into some serious problems. And I at that point in time feel that they are only and awesomely warranted.
Sure.
If that cop has to grab a stun gun, that's what he feels he needs to do. If he has to grab a firearm, that's what he feels he needs to do. These situations that keep coming up because people are not respecting authority, these same people that are not respecting authority didn't respect their parents. And it's
or,
their parents.
Or it came down from their parents because their parents didn't respect authority.
There you go.
So as far as they know,
on the head right there.
As far as they know, they could give a shit about what the cops have to say because mom and dad also told them, fuck the cops.
Exactly.
You're not wrong.
Exactly.
So
that'll bring me into a whole other topic, which I don't know how much time you have.
We got 2 hours.
But that's another thing. You know, the parents don't respect authority. The parents are getting free money from authority.
Sure.
So it's a federal money game, and it's some state money game. But the money that comes into some of these people's households are more than I make on a decent job, and I'm
work really fucking decent job, but I'm still...
You're still barely, you're still rolling almost check to check.
Yeah, well, yeah.
You know what I mean?
But I don't understand how, you know, I bust my ass to drive a brand new truck, but they get the welfare Mercedes-Benzes and the BMWs and the... Some of these trucks they drive, I haven't even seen on, like, Motor Trend or Hot Rod.
Right,
just
right.
Myself, it's all... Now, that's not respecting authority, because here you are taking your welfare check and flipping it into the dope game, you know, and crystallizing a whole lot of population with prostitution, with habits, with this and that, and stealing and looting.
Not to mention that you really just don't
and
have...
That's where it comes in.
You really
welfare
don't have as much
feeding,
energy.
Drug markets, welfare is feeding.
Oh, has been for
markets,
years.
Welfare is feeding the whole nine yards. And now everybody's playing the police as the bad guy when they're just trying to do their job, when they have an overwhelmingly supply to the negative by the parents that don't respect authority.
Oh, they already have.
They're frauding the system across the board.
The deck is stacked against them when they get in their car and go to work every day.
It really is.
And you just don't have the energy to put up that much of a fight when you worked an 8 or 10 hour day. All you want to do is go home and relax and clean your house and take care of your things. But if you're going back to, you know, you got your money for free, you didn't go to work all day, you're not going to respect what you have.
You're not.
That's it.
You're not going to respect what you have. You're not going to respect anything. Everything is hand to mouth.
Yeah, exactly.
Everything is today and tomorrow, but fuck the next day beyond that, because it's not even given to us. That's their mentality, the people that don't respect authority. That is the mentality. There is no 2 days out from now. It's let's hustle for today so we can buy tomorrow. So we can hustle tomorrow, but we ain't 3 days out there yet.
You're not wrong.
Because when the cops come in, they were just 2 days out there. Everything, it's a shatter game. Look at Gates Pub. What in the hell happened there? I don't know. How that place even got to be the way it got to be over that Saturday, I don't know. 150 people packed into a place that's good for 50 people. I wouldn't want to be there. I respect authority. There's got to be a sign on the wall somewhere. And when it got that thick, I'd be like, nah, that's a bad vibe.
You don't even need to see that sign to know that when you walk in the door and there's way too many people in there, the scene isn't giving you that vibe anyways. I wouldn't want to be there, dude. I mean, and I used to work there. Emerson used to work there. I mean,
how are you going to get a drink if there's three times the occupancy?
You're not.
You know
what I mean?
You're
like, waiting forever.
You're not showing up there to get drunk. You're not showing up there to get a drink. You can't be showing up there to get the food, because it's got to be 2 hours out there at that point in time. So why are you there? There's something about, I want to see some shit pop off. There had to be some knowledge. Something was going to go down that night, and nobody said nothing. Nobody called the cops before it happened.
Well, number one, no bar is going to call the police in general, because they got to deal with
rumors in the hood that the police don't care, that Gates doesn't care. Oh yeah, I was in the hood today, all day.
Sure.
It's an ugly scene. There was actually a shooting on the street that borders my shop today.
Fremont?
So the back of my little shop, the street next to my shop, that was all closed off for a shooting today. At lunchtime, actually. Right at lunchtime, high noon, there was a shooting just off of my shop. It's probably not even in the news yet. I checked, but I couldn't find anything. But everybody in my shop said, yeah, we heard 4 shots. It sounded like gunshots. And I was like, man, I'm glad I was not here. Was everybody inside the shop, you know?
Let me just say this. It's only April. Wait till July. Wait till it's hot and everybody's out. Ugh.
Yeah. It's going to be, I tell you, I think that this year is going to be worse than last year. Last year was bad. The year before that was bad. I think this year is going to be bad. The city of Rochester, I love the cops. I really do. You know, it's not their fault. there's a serious problem in the city of Rochester, and it's not even being remotely looked at or addressed on any level.
Because I don't think they have any standards. Sure. I don't think they have an idea of how to even go about trying to fix the problem. That's why it's overlooked and not looked at like it should be. They don't have a clue on what to do or how to fix it because it's so deep rooted in so many different levels of the community that they're just fuck it.
And we're at the point now where the whole younger generation is already, you know, let's say there was a time when I was about 20 or 15 when I'm like, Jesus, this is getting bad. You know what I mean? And then the kids that have grown up in that same thing only know that now. They've never known it to be like it was when we were growing up where, you know, everybody was hanging out together and it was a cool vibe. They've never known that. It's always been disrespect authority.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Well, thank you for the call.
I remember being young downtown. You know, Sibley's was still there. McCurdy's was still there. You couldn't mouth off to a cop down there at that point in time.
No, you used to be able to. There was a lot of stuff down there, a lot of popular businesses. You know, you had your Midtown Mall that still existed. It was thriving. There were no fights in the mall. There were no...
Oh, no way. Maybe one or two
fights a school year that would happen outside of school, and that would be it.
And then any other fights would be taken somewhere else by there was, you know, different gangs and little hangouts and cliques and clubs or whatever. I remember back, you know, but they wouldn't take it downtown. They would take it back to their neighborhood. But even then, I remember now, the generation of people that did not respect authority. But back then, I feel like people in the school district had a way to deal with them. There was Josh Lost in high school.
Sure was.
Here's where we put the bad kids right before they get to go to jail. And this is your bottom line.
I was supposed to go to Josh Lofton from Jefferson. I went to Jefferson when it was still a high school. And
right.
Mine was more of like truancy, shit like that. I never really got into too much trouble. But mine was just more of not being at school. So they told my mother they threw the pins petition on you, and then they're like, hey, the next step is Josh Lofton. And nobody wanted to go to Josh Lofton back then because it was all loaded with the G Boys and LOD and the Black Mob. From the 80s. I mean, we had a serious gang problem here in the 80s. I was growing up
back then, with that serious gang problem, I know there's probably things I don't know about because I was young back then. But back then compared to now, it's 100 times worse now.
Sure.
You know, where back then I wouldn't care. I would walk wherever I wanted to walk. Today, I was like, man, as soon as I came out of the complex, I was like, man, there's a weird vibe. There's a bad vibe. Let me just haul ass over there. But take in everything around me. Let me haul ass over there and get right the fuck back in. And that's when I heard there was a shooting over lunchtime. And I was out on those fucking streets, and I was like, man, I had a bad vibe. And I didn't even know what was going around. It would have been like to like my 5 o'clock. You know what I mean? It would have been happening at about my 5 o'clock.
Sure.
Bullets were fucking flying around. You know, and it's like, that's under my skin.
Absolutely, absolutely. Codename, thanks for the call, brother. We're glad you tuned in tonight. We still got lots to get to, a lot more shit that I'm sure you'll be interested in. Stay tuned in if you can.
Absolutely,
if
man.
Not, keep watching. Call in. We love you, brother.
All right, brother.
And be safe out there.
Be safe.
Later.
Hey.
Good buddy, Codename.
Glad
to hear from him. That guy's usually got some pretty interesting stuff to talk about.
Sure. And he's not far off from how most of us feel.
Yep.
Kevin, go to work.
I will.
Go to work. You know what else you could do? Go to break.
Yes.
Oh,
but before
yes.
we go to break, ladies and gentlemen, let me direct you to shop.com/amazingu. That's amazing with the letter U. They carry all the top partner sites. You got Home Depot, TravelByPriceline.com, Advance Auto Parts, among many others. You can download the ShopBuddy app and earn instant cash back today. That's shop.com/amazingyou. We can also check out Viking Graphics. They do stickers, posters, car wraps, whatever else you can think of. I'm sure he'll take care of it. You call 585-690-5731 and ask for Stan.
Stan the man.
Stick a Stan. That's Viking Graphics.
Also, check us out this Thursday night, Channel 18 Late Nights at 12:30, technically Friday, for the best of the Monday medicine, condensed down to a half-hour show. I still wouldn't let your kids watch it, but you can play it for them because it's edited. Plus, why the hell are they up so late? They have school tomorrow. Send those pricks to bed and watch the best of the Monday medicine Thursdays on Time Warner 18. And we will be right back.
Said you're not mine.
Yeah, he said he was in some kind of like
prick competition.
Yeah. No, he was in some kind of work seminar, some boring ass thing where you had to like sit there all fucking day to get some kind of training certificate or something. And he said instead of paying attention, he was trying to figure out how many miles of dick he's laid in his life.
Oh.
So he's trying to calculate like how many girls and how many humps per second and like.
That was the calculation. Like, what was his calculation to come up with that?
Well, first of all, 7.8 inches times
5,000.
How many humps per second?
All right.
Times how many seconds you last? Okay. Times how many girls you fucked?
Times how many times you fucked them?
Right.
Comes up with what? Wow. What did he come up with?
8. How many miles of dick he's laid?
I know, but what did he ever come up with the?
I don't know. Should
he call
him?
Can
you guys do outgoing calls?
Absolutely.
On your cell phone?
Just 1 mile.
Hey, Dad.
Any mile.
Hey, I'm on the radio now. I have one lifeline. I need to know
how many
miles of dick have you laid?
Oh!
Hey, it's my dad. Yes!
I know that my promos for UnderTheSkin.tv aren't really that visually interesting. So I decided to promote with what I think is possibly the best way to get your attention. This is my dogger. Isn't he adorable? That was a rhetorical question. I already know. He is. Tune in tonight to the Monday Medicine, 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. UnderTheSkin.tv. I'm sorry. I didn't really mean that. Yeah. I'm sorry, I feel so dirty now.
The skin. Who's this?
Brian Sherwalover.
All right.
Hey, what's up,
lady?
Hello.
Sorry.
This is Brian.
Yeah, go ahead. Talk to Brian. You're on live with Brian Bieber.
Let's do it.
I thought it's just kids. Hey.
text message again. I was like, over here, I was like,
no, go ahead. Wait, no, talk away.
Let her know that you're here, Brian.
I'm here.
For you.
I'm here for you.
He's here for you.
Put him on camera, Glenn.
No,
so
go ahead.
Can
you're,
see
on,
him.
You're on live with on Brian.
Brian.
Oh, go ahead.
He's right. See, he's right here in front of a mic. There he. Oh, shy girl.
You shy girl?
Ooh.
Let me. All right. Yeah. Okay. I'll tell you what. I think I know. Let me ask you this. Now you're taking a look at this basically this bachelor auction that is on under the skin.tv tonight. Here's Brian.
5'9", he's a cancer. He loves to fish.
Now tell me this. Would you let him possibly just put his hand down the small of your back until it ran down to your fanny cheek?
That's an intimate moment.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, all right.
It's your mom on the phone, by the way.
Would you allow...
Mom, is that you?
Go to bed, Mom! Go to bed!
Would you... Now, this is... I feel bad because the lead singers usually do get all the attention. He just sat there being coy in the background. But let me ask you this. If he came up behind you in the hall and reached around your front hips to unbutton your pants, would you let that happen?
After study hall?
Yes.
Yes.
I believe the romance novel is coming out in the fall.
Yes. He's replacing Fabio.
Woodhaven is a new Twilight.
This isn't like Twilight vampire bullshit.
Yeah, this Woodhaven is a new Twilight.
It is.
Yeah, please continue. All right, now what if he were to run his fingers slightly up the back of your neck and into your hair before making a fist and possibly pressing you into the wall and gently kissing your neck? Would you let that happen?
Yes.
What a slut. Holy shit, I can't believe this fucking
happened.
What
the hell, man?
What the fuck do we? What kind of fucking fans do we have?
Gross.
Jesus
gross.
Christ. I can't fucking believe this. I try to run a Christian fucking show here. What the fuck?
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry.
I have the weird.
I'll tell you what. No, I gotta say, call back. I'm fucking sexy over
that.
Here.
I didn't even expect that.
That was good.
That was a good one.
Slot.
That just means that the ball is in his.
That's bar. Right. You know where to find him. And honestly, I won't even hang up on you.
That was his girlfriend.
Back.
This kid's going to go home and get his ass kicked now, dude. She's going to be like, you let him talk
brothers.
To me like that?
She's got 14 brothers.
Oh, shit.
How could you do this to me?
We're ready.
Yeah.
All right, everybody. Welcome back to the Monday Medicine here on undertheskin.tv. It's right up here. Phone number right down
the
here.
Again are 585-300-4887.
Still plenty to talk about. One of the things we've got here just happened this week. I think it was Friday.
Yep.
Around 9 o'clock. Your new first lady, Bruce Jenner.
Bruce Jenner.
There you go. Get your pussy out. I guess not shocking the world at this point because everybody knew that it was going to happen, but he did an interview with Diane Sawyer, a 2-hour interview, basically talking about how he is, he will be a living as a woman from now on.
Actually, he said, he will no longer do it. This was his last interview. I think it was his first, actually, major interview. And he will no longer be doing interviews. And when he reappears by the end of the year, he will be a woman.
Now, did he say what his name was going to be?
He did not because he didn't want to let it out of the bag yet. And basically, he just didn't want it to
get out. The ball bag?
Yes, the ball bag.
We did have some of the names we had. Bruce Seal.
Yes.
Tarno came up with Brucey.
Brucey.
And I came up with Confusing McGender Pants.
Which was good.
I thought it was all right. And then on the way home tonight, Bruce Gender.
Bruce Gender.
Why didn't that come out? I have no idea. I guess I don't care that he is a female or going to be a female. I think it's a lot less shocking to us. I think I care a lot less, but the reason that it was so shocking to a lot of people, typically 5-10 years older than we are, is because they grew up with him being the greatest athlete on the planet.
Yep.
He won the decathlon gold medal.
And he beat the Russian guy who was supposed to be like the Ivan Drago, like the machine funded by the Russian government and all their money. And he was supposed to be unbeatable, and Jenner wiped the floor with him.
Well, I will say this. Like I said, I don't think it matters as much to us. I'm not as surprised by it, nor do I really care. I think it's interesting that this transition is going on in the mainstream media. It's a big deal. You know, they definitely, as a family, know how to market themselves. Smart business women. And thank you. Got that in there. Even the fact that he got a 2-hour interview to talk about how he looked in a dress or whatever he did. I didn't really watch the interview because I didn't care. It was a highly rated interview, though. A lot of people did watch. Millions of people. They got to watch him break down, cry, hug
Diane Sawyer. She asked him at one point if it was a stunt for ratings for people to watch upcoming seasons of either his show, because I think he has one coming out, or Kardashians.
I think he did get approved for an 8-episode new show.
I think it's more of a docudrama or something like that.
But it's going to be on a major network. So even
it's going to be on E, because I think E owns their lives.
I think they own the Kardashians, but do they own the Jenners?
He was part of that.
Well, he's part of it, but he's not really...
It's on E is when it came out.
All right, fair enough.
It's a reality show about being transgendered.
Yes. Great.
He looks
That's what it is.
Way better than 40% of the chicks I banged. I'm not even lying.
Oh, man.
So I really can't be that mad at him about it, you know?
Said he's been dressing up in women's clothes since he was 7 or 8 years old. He used to sneak into his sister's closet, and he would wear her dresses around, and he's always wanted to be a woman. His soul is a woman, is what he said.
So what you're saying is the Ivan Drago of the Olympics got beat by a girl?
Yes.
All right, fair
enough. And that
was
the joke at the end of it, because they contacted that guy and said how did he feel about it. He said he had no problem with him becoming a woman. Whatever he wanted to do in his life was okay. He's just mad he lost to a girl.
Well, there you go. A girl in a man's body. But what is the decathlon? How many?
It's
obviously 10 events, but what 10? Is it like swimming and skiing and biking? Isn't that, didn't we have two famous Americans that were competing for that both lost? Maybe like 15, 20 years ago, maybe 25 years ago at this point.
It's the javelin. I think it's the hammer throw, the discus.
That guy is throwing the hammer down.
He sure is. Woo!
Sorry.
I can tell you all of them.
It's the 100-meter hurdle.
Yeah, read them off.
100 meters, long jump, shot put, high jump, 400 meters, 110-meter hurdles, discus, pole vault, javelin, 1,500 meters.
That guy ripped the...
Did he lose
any of them?
I'm not sure. I mean, yeah, you just have to have the best overall of all of them to win?
Sure, I would imagine so.
That's a point system.
Yeah, it's a point system. You wouldn't have to win all 10.
Nope.
What was he terrible at? Anything with throwing?
No, he actually was pretty good with that.
Lamar's limp-wristed throwing style, specially formulated javelin... I liked the Revenge of the Nerds take on that. It was the wobbly javelin. He chucked it. Yep. You know, good for him. And he went, yay! And he
Mino
won.
Mino Lamar.
And they got to keep their...
Didn't Booger win the tricycle race?
No, that was... No, that was not Booger.
It was Ogre, wasn't it?
No, it was the Chinese guy.
Oh, yeah.
It looks like Bobby Lee. Was Dei Chi, Dei Chi, la 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 la. I can't play it on the guitar, though. But
you should learn.
I should. But that is a great video. He had to chug a beer between between each event. That song I've listened to probably 100 times on YouTube.
Sure.
I'm not going to lie. Maybe we could wrap up the segment with that. But... Yeah, so he was the best athlete, Wheaties box. I mean, this would be the equivalent of, like, The Rock coming out and being like, hey, eat my pussy. I want to be a woman now. You know what I mean? That's how I think that would kind of blow my mind in that. The Rock
turned into Buck Angel?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Fair enough.
Oh, he's got the video. Play this song. What a great song. And there's a name for the name of the song, and I'm not sure if it's an actual...
Oh, it's a great recording.
Oh, yeah. Yeah! Woo! Come on, Ogre! Get him up off the ground! Nobody can beat the tri-lambs, baby.
Oh, that's right.
Lambda, lambda, lambda.
Look how they're carrying them.
Times are changing, Betty. These nerds are a threat to our way of life. Times are changing, Betty.
They're going to get internet in a show.
And he's going to... And the old Louis Skolnick's going to bang old Betty in the old Vader suit. In the space room at the fucking
the walk
carnival.
On the moonwalk or the walk on the moon or whatever it was. I don't know. I you know, the world was a buzz, I guess, or the country was. Or the media was. I think that's what it was. Holy shit, look at this fire in Baltimore.
Wow.
Wow, that is crazy. We have no way to look at that.
Joe, before we went to the governor,
nope.
We saw a man...
Dude, that is a block big right there.
Sure.
Who...
Breaking news.
And basically was trying to
massive building fire in Baltimore. That is a huge fire. Look at the size of those cars around it. These guys are not screwing around. And even the black leaders in the community are like, we don't want anybody arrested or tased or tear gassed because... and we just want everybody to go home and we'll talk about this tomorrow. That is not happening.
No.
This thing is huge. It must be a factory or something.
Gotta be
that
something.
Is multiple buildings. I mean, they're spraying what looks like a squirt gun on the scene on the left there.
It's an Olive Garden.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Oh, my God.
But, yeah, dude, the whole Jenner thing, I don't know. Give me a break. And everyone's saying, oh, why now? His explanation was he's 65 years old. And
he wants to retire a woman.
He wants to be able to live the rest of his life as a woman and not regret it if something was to happen and he would die and not be able to actually live the way he felt he should have lived his whole life, which is as a woman.
Honestly, it's 2015. I think if he came out 20 years ago, it would be frowned upon. Maybe frowned upon.
Every one of his wives knew he had this issue. He told all of his wives in certain parts, not really, some of them he said he didn't explain fully why he wanted to become a woman or that he wanted to become
sure.
a woman, but he gave all of his wives hints that he was struggling with inner demons of his gender.
Well, I guess that's what it is, but you know, maybe he did have to wait because I think, you know, there's so much acceptance or forced acceptance right now. Maybe that's what they were shooting for. If you force people to accept it, eventually they just won't care as much. I'm sure there's a ton of people that are still to this day, you know, small-minded about this type of thing. It doesn't really bother me. Maybe it's because I didn't grow up with them. Maybe it's because everything's been jammed down your throat. But I, you know, we've had friends and people that hang around that were obviously not straight.
Sure.
For our entire lives, be it like your, you know, one of your mother's friends or whatever it is, I don't think anybody cares. I think it's widely accepted now. I still think it's ridiculous that they're, you know, that even gay people are still fighting to get married. I don't think that's a problem at all. That's never bothered me. I don't see how people have the time to care about what other people do.
Yeah.
My day is busy. My day is busy as hell. I'm working. I'm planning for the show. You know, the people that don't want these people to get married don't have hobbies. Get a hobby. Start a web show. Talk about anything. And stop bothering these people that just want to live. That's all it is.
I mean, but it comes from that. It gets conservative Christians, dude, is what it comes from. They don't.
It's not just conservative Christians.
Right.
ISIS is chopping heads off probably right now because people. They said they were luring people. ISIS members are sitting there donning a bikini, posting some ad, and then luring people, and then just murdering and decapitating those people that show up. It's extreme religion, you know?
Look at Russia.
Sure.
Well, look at this. We have a severe overpopulation problem. If these guys want to be gay as hell and not have more kids and adopt the ones that are out there with no parents, God bless them. Literally. God, please bless them. Stop making a big deal out of it. I don't know. I'm just always amazed.
And the thing with the interview with Jenner, all of his kids from all the previous marriages were on the show and basically said they all supported him. Not one Kardashian kid or Jenner kid, the girls, they declined. I think they left message or
left messages. Hey, Dad, I'll see you at Christmas.
Yep. Yep.
Do you want anything to do with your pussy?
He said the only one that actually, he said that Khloe Kardashian is having a hard time with it because she's always looked up to him as like her second or her father figure.
Right.
He said that the one that's the most accepting is Kim Kardashian, and she wasn't at first but came around because of something that Kanye said to her, which was something to the effect of...
Eat my pussy?
Basically. Was basically...
I'm a gay fish.
I think it was more of Kanye said to her, you know, even I got the most beautiful kids, most beautiful wife, blah, 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 blah. And...
No pussy.
Yeah. And just basically be you
is what
he said.
Jealousy. It's just jealousy. He's around that many pussies. He just wants to be involved.
You think he's affected by just being around the girls?
Yeah.
Dude, if you saw the last couple...
Pussmosis.
Dude, the last couple years of that show, dude, that dude was nothing but a fucking... A freaking doormat, dude. He just got browbeat and pushed in the corner constantly.
Yeah, you wore a dress once. You understand how he feels.
Yeah.
Are you going to have one day.
Are you going to have to edit out pussmosis? Is that even a thing you have to edit out? You might be able to leave that in. That's clever.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Evan.
You're welcome, finally.
Are you upset about Bruce Jenner?
Me?
Yes.
No, I've seen you in a dress. It doesn't bother me. I don't give a
You're
shit.
You're infatuated with me wearing a dress.
Yeah, I am. Let's do
it's
it
really
again.
Weird, dude.
It actually, you made a great woman. It made the intro.
It's probably your best moments, actually. You just gave into it. You accepted your tits and your bitchiness.
Yeah. And I don't have to have a period every month.
You know what?
Well... Kevin!
Kevin!
I was on my period.
You should show up in a dress.
My Kevin period.
Can we make a bet here?
No.
That you will make it to work every time or...
Warning, the following program contains...
No.
Six months, we'll make it for the opener for the next season.
They wouldn't allow me to do that.
Why wouldn't they?
They wouldn't.
You wouldn't be able to cook in a dress if
no.
you lost a bet? Are
no,
you kidding me?
I'm
talking to your boss.
Yeah, I think we should work on this.
You wouldn't allow it.
Flipping cakes.
I already told you that was the one and only time you'll ever see that happen. I sucked it up. I fucking wore the dress.
I play the video by myself down here all the time.
That's scary. In your underwear, probably.
No underwear, believe me.
Just in that chair, just squeaking away. Just fucking... Oh, KP, I wish you would wear that dress every show.
Get out of my windows.
Tony was going to up the ante, which I didn't think was possible, but he said that the next bet with you was going to be like a three-peat spray tan.
Wow.
So you would be just as orange as any of the orangest chicks that you see on the internet. Or he would. For some reason, I don't see it going in your favor, though.
Yeah, somehow, some way, the odds are stacked against me.
Oh, man. They always are. And you picked, who'd you pick, Denver?
I took Denver.
Oh, yes, you did. Goddamn Super Bowl.
But I did win that trophy.
You did win the trophy.
I won that trophy and then lost the Super Bowl bet, and Kavina showed up to the show.
Yes, she did. Kavina Jenner.
Kavina Jenner.
Oh, yes. You would have made, you know what? You probably looked like Chloe back in the day because she had shoulders like you.
You're probably right.
And you had boobs like her, so it worked out.
It did.
All right, what else we got in national news here?
Look at this building up here. There's like a quarter of the city on fire.
Yeah.
Jeez, I mean, you could throw that on camera.
Wow.
I don't care about stealing WJZ's info.
Which one is it?
Breaking news, official. We won't let cowards run Baltimore.
Wow, look at that. Flames, ladies and gentlemen.
That is a
Baltimore
big
is
fire.
Burning.
Yeah, compare that to the little tiny cars that are next to it.
Yeah, that's huge, man.
Is it even a controllable fire at this point?
No.
So that's just going to spread. Let's hope it's not in the heart of the city.
It is. It's Baltimore. It's downtown Baltimore.
Dude, that thing burned down quick. 80% of the walls are just tinder now, dude. Just gone.
Is that walls or other buildings, or is that smokestacks?
I think that was one large building that just, that's probably what's left standing of the structure.
Did you just see that lady casually walking away from the inferno?
She had to light a smoke, man. Yeah, just rolled up. Got my cools lit, bitch.
Yeah, we filmed The Wire here. This is all right.
Yeah, dude.
At least it's warm.
You kidding me?
I can't start a barbecue. And these guys started a whole block on fire. Ugh, that's so
rough, wonder what
man.
That building. It had to be a factory of some sort. Oh, the National Guard troops are now on the ground.
Yeah, they have declared a state of emergency, which I believe means you can ride snowmobiles anywhere on the street if you want to.
Yep. That's
all
what
your ATVs, whatever. It's a state of emergency. Do what you got
to
do.
We look forward to here in Rochester. State of emergency says all your snowmobilers and four-wheelers can now ride to the bar.
That's pretty much what happens. The one guy with a car shows up and unlocks it, and everybody comes up, and then one guy shoots seven people. That's just how it works. Welcome to Rochester. Yeah, this is pretty serious. We earlier saw these guys roll up. They set a CVS on fire. They roll up to put the fire out. Fire department shows up, turns on the hose. One guy came up and stabbed the hose couple times.
He stabbed it once and then came back and stabbed it again.
And then rode off on a stolen bike.
He had a gas mask on, the guy that did it. They're not going to find that guy unless somebody snitches on him.
Let's talk about the pictures.
I think the whole snitching thing started out of Baltimore.
Well,
all those
see.
Videos and shit of no snitching and all that.
Let's see who we got here. There's one picture where it looks like the guy is throwing a punch. They were just straight up. Oh, there he is, Bruce Jenner.
He was throwing a punch.
All right,
a pussy.
This is looting a 7-Eleven.
Are those Wu-Tangs on his pants?
I have no idea, but when's the last time you saw a jean jacket with leather sleeves? Maybe this guy needs to loot something.
It's a tunnel.
He should have looted a Target instead. Get yourself
now,
a new coat.
Now, do you call that Deather or Lenham?
I like Deather.
It's a Deather jacket?
Yes, I like Deather.
Got an entire rack of tobacco products there. All the Skull, no Newports.
This dude's got a couple slushies, dude. He doesn't care.
Oh, it's fill your own slushy day with any container you wanted. Bring in the skull of your enemy and fill it up with cherry coke.
Yeah, this was.
This is them finally showing up to stop this 7-Eleven.
Does that
looting.
Look like police or military?
It looks like Adam Keene.
Yeah, Adam Keene is on the scene right now in Baltimore.
Yeah, it's a shot from Afghanistan. He's sending over.
Yeah.
No, that's down the street.
What else we got there? Yeah, this is just. Just the lootings. We'll throw on some masks. Some people won't even.
Some of these people are so screwed.
This dude's got as many donuts as he can carry.
Newport.
Those are packs of Newports.
Are they? Yeah. God for him.
I figured for sure that was your brother.
So it looks like the old days of
donuts.
Looks like the old days of Robin Mobile on the Run.
Look at Robin Givens in the background doing a selfie there.
Actually, it looks like Erykah Badu back there with the hair.
She maybe came it's in both for some, of them.
Yes.
What's the next picture?
Your tasty cakes.
Loaves of bread. Oh, is that Debbie's?
Oh,
little
no.
Debbie's?
Oh, Entenmann's. Please say it is an Entenmann's. I
Marlboro
love those.
Marlboro menthols. Yeah. Nobody wants Marlboro
menthols.
No,
those stayed
Dude,
there.
Entenmann's cheesecake, Danish cheesecake or whatever is the best.
I like the crumb cake, and I like their stupid waxy chocolate donuts.
Yeah, they are good.
Ugh. The dedicated looter and flip-flops trenching through the broken glass.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Somebody beat that down with a 2x4.
Yay! Yay!
He was just informed that he's got the rest of the day off.
Look at my breast.
I see you showed up late to work, sir.
Look at my black and milds. My wood tips and my plastic tips in the other
Time
hand.
Time to go home.
He is good to go. Oh, have tomorrow off, too. No, this is a guy that's got a bottle of vodka in his hand.
And a ginger's.
And he's stealing a purse.
Trying to steal a purse from a couple of skirts, man.
Yeah, he is.
See,
three
that's
skirts.
When you need decathlon champion Bruce Jenner in a skirt to just...
Oh, he will hockey
yes.
kick you right in the dick.
Yes.
Oh, my God. It's over for you. Yeah, that's a pretty sad sight. What did they leave there? What's on the right rack that they didn't want?
The Hulk covered by Funyuns.
Oh, the beef jerky?
Yeah.
Ah, ruins my teeth. What is she planking? she rolled into the store to start planking?
Oh, everybody for a 10 count.
This sums up the whole deal right there.
Look at that, dude. He is white. He is winding up from the bottom of a shoe, dude.
Now,
like,
look, if you haven't noticed, in his right hand, that's a knife. That is a fucking knife.
Oh, wow, sure is.
Yes, he is not. I mean, they were just straight up attacking
Whitey. And if you see this other
Whitey.
Guy, it looks like Whitey's trying to pull a gun. He's
no,
reaching
he's
for something.
Dipping back. Yeah, he's reaching screaming. For somebody else. He's reaching for his girlfriend. Ah!
It looks like his leg's buckling, possible ankle injury. You look at that, dude.
That is how you break some ankles. This is 2K15 right here.
Yikes. Can we get this picture uploaded to Reddit for photoshopping and see if somebody can put a stew on that garbage can right there for us?
Oh, beautiful.
Oh, I'm sure we could.
And look at everybody behind him. It
put
looks
a
like
microphone
that,
in his hand.
It looks like the commercial for Mortal Kombat 10 where fight! Look at all the people just standing there like, oh, Whitey's about to get it.
Security guard's not even moved by any of this.
There's a couple cops just hanging out behind that crowd just like, I'm not doing anything. You doing anything? No.
That guy's ankle has snapped.
Look at that thing.
Look at the guy in the background in the striped shirt just having a beer. Just looking off, not even paying
it's
attention.
It's like, oh, well, this is happening.
Wow, yeah, that guy's Monday. About to get it.
Oh, man.
Next. Oh, all right.
Was just running from tear gas there, or he's got a couple bagels on his arms.
A couple loaves of bagels?
Oh, my God. Yeah, these guys just...
What, does he got scratch-offs?
Oh, I see so much orange in this.
Black power. Jesus Christ. Stop it.
Oh, is that what that shirt says?
Yeah, I mean, look. This is only happening because it's a you know, I really, truly believe that none of these people would be doing any of this one at a time. It's just you get caught up and you're like, well, if everybody's getting something free, why not?
Yeah.
My 8 packs of Mike and Ike's.
Yeah.
A pack of sour cream and onion chips. I mean, you're going out to loot. That's, I'm just not stopping at 7-Eleven. I'm going to a major store.
Couple of things.
Bigger
of,
doors.
Of Whatchasets ketchup chips.
Whatchasets?
That's the name of the company.
All right. I'll take it.
I used to love those chips.
Yeah,
whoa.
Those cupboards are bare.
Scaling that counter.
Grab me the TVs off those things. I mean, I would like to make
just
out.
Just a surveillance camera.
Yeah. Rip the BNC wires out of the wall.
Yeah.
You got to love the looters that pick up the little freaking thing, the little, what the hell they call that, where you can put all your shit in it, the little basket. He just walks in and picks the basket up like, seven items or less.
Again, it's orange.
Yes, it is.
You'd have to put a hood on just to cover the fact that you were white.
Is he taking a step or throwing a kick?
That's he's jumping over.
Yeah, oh, I think he's coming back.
I want seconds.
Oh, Jesus.
He's coming in like, hey, man, that's my box of M&Ms.
Oh, my God.
There you have it. There's our coverage on the pictures coming out.
Yikes.
Baltimore.
That's crazy, folks. That is crazy. Baltimore's burning to the ground tonight. Thugs attacking city, says the Baltimore mayor. They interviewed some people that were right there on the block while it was burning and everything. And a lot of these people that are from the area are saying the people doing this are not from the area.
Now, they're saying that what's on fire here is the new construction of the Mary Harvin Center.
Oh.
I don't know what the Mary Harvin Center is, but it was big. Maybe it was a medical center.
A woman's shelter.
Yeah, anything that the community obviously needed that it is not getting anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that sucks. Could you imagine? So it wasn't even finished yet. This was a construction site. Oh, those guys got to be pissed. You know, there was like 400 guys on that scene that were so angry just having to work and build this thing because that's what happens when you work. You get mad during work. And now to come back and be like, oh, start over. Oh.
See, you remember during the LA riots, dude? When they were looting all the Chinese-owned stores and these motherfuckers were on the roofs and in front of them with fucking pistols and shotguns just firing on anybody that came near the place?
Dude. Sure. Yeah, the Korean store owners?
Yeah.
Well, they went for the freaking construction.
I'm telling you, none of those stores got messed with. These dudes are... You going up to a store that's got a bunch of Koreans on the roof just sniping you?
Scatter shooting at your feet with buckshot.
Yeah.
Everybody's getting hit.
Mm-hmm. The Mary Harvin Transformation Center, CDC, located in Baltimore. Our vision is to restore communities by first restoring the individuals and families that make up those communities. The program is... We're on fire!
There it is, folks.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Let's restore the community. Yeah, now you can start. Restore this, you dumb son of a bitch. Oh, my God.
Yikes.
That is brutal.
What do you think? Take a quick break?
Yeah, we could do that.
All right.
You want to hit us up with a read?
Oh, I sure will. Before we go to break, let me direct you to shop.com/amazingu. That's the word amazing. With the letter U at the end of it. They carry all the top partner sites, Aeropostale, Bass Pro Shops, Macy's, Saks Fifth Avenue, among many other. Download the Shop Buddy app and earn instant cash back today. That's shop.com/amazingu. Let me also direct you to iShutter Photo. You'll get your senior pictures, custom photo shoots, weddings, corporate events, and whatever else you need. Call 585-905-8353 to set up an appointment today.
And also, check out the best of the Monday Medicine. That's this show, condensed to the best half hour. Hopefully we'll get to it soon. On Channel 18, WBGT-TV, Time Warner 18, at 12:30 on the late night block, Thursday night.
Technically Friday.
And check out what you can't watch online on your TV. That's Channel 18, late night Thursdays, 12:30 a.m. Check it out. And we will be...
Oh, when we come back, did you preview that voicemail that we got?
Yes.
You did preview it?
Yes,
is it worth
the
play?
Sure.
I haven't heard
He'll
it yet.
He'll know what it is.
So when we come back, may I play it over break?
Sure.
When you
want to
come back to it?
Yeah, yes. We'll come back and you can play it right when we come back.
Oh, you want to do a sitting still reaction?
Sure, because I'd like to know what it means. All right, and we will be right back.
Ghostbusters, and you're watching UnderTheSkin.tv.
All right, go.
All right, so Rush, New York Ghostbusters, and you're watching UnderTheSkin.tv.
All right, abortion. Up or down, Goose?
I'm pro-abortion.
Yeah, you are. You'll kick a bitch right in the belly.
Down
Caper.
Some stairs.
Pro-choice?
Yes.
Nick?
Have as many as you want.
That's
crazy.
Yeah, that is crazy.
That's crazy.
Can we get...
I almost want a limit.
No, why?
Yes.
You can't do that to people.
Then who's paying for them? Then you're back on welfare.
As long as you pay for them, have as many as you want.
Oh, well, that's a different story.
Yeah, but they all can't pay for them.
Then don't get knocked up. Get your fucking genitals irradiated.
You had
should
dude,
we do
that's,
that right out of the pocket?
Can we microwave
right
out of the, your can we microwave your balls on camera right now?
North Carolina just paid back like I think they're paying back like $50,000 per person that they like steamed their vaginas closed.
Nice.
What?
How do you do that? I love and clams.
You don't eat
me
clams
too.
That are
wow.
closed. You don't they're eat welfare. Clams that are closed. What's wrong with you?
I eat them steamed though.
They if they're closed.
What? No way. The women on their welfare
open.
Department
dead.
In the 50s.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dead
if you,
vagina.
If
what's
you
happened
come
here?
A
chick with a steamed vagina, you're like, that's just dead.
Just turn your mic
that's
down.
A dead vagina.
Order, order, order. Sorry, everybody. We had to get some order in here. That's what the gavel
was
for.
That was true. North Carolina.
Hello, Joshua.
Well, I'm not right. saying, you know, do that, but, hey, listen, if you have five and you can't pay for them and you're leeching off the government,
yeah, but how-
guess what? Walk through this nuclear power plant for a couple hours and have as much unprotected sex as you want.
Chemical castrating.
Sure.
After a certain amount of children.
I mean...
Burn your dick off? They just fucking acid your dick? Hey!
Just fucking take an x-ray machine, point it at your balls for a couple minutes...
Listen, I don't care what you do for fun, but that's
yeah,
not what
I mean,
I do
Jesus
fun,
Christ,
right?
why are you eating
Jesus
a burger?
Fucking
A.
Pro choice.
All right, have stupid people make more kids.
I don't
you
want stupid people
there
to make.
There you go.
But you're against
then why is
the
my,
death penalty.
Then why is my yes. My remedy so
why
horrible?
Is that?
It's not.
Well, there you go.
Why is it okay to kill babies but not adults?
Whoa. Hey. Hey, good topic.
Glenn,
continue.
Why is it okay to kill babies but not adults?
Because babies taste delicious.
baby pussy.
Right, you know what? That's they don't that's a topic for another day.
What? What is this?
They don't contribute to society. Leeches.
We have the power to create.
So you're willing to kill potential but not destroyed, wasted potential.
Nah,
that
not,
seems weird, doesn't it?
Kinetic,
doesn't that
no.
seem a little weird,
it's
though?
Not about kinetic.
Don't like, bring hey, science I, into this.
I want to kill something
just,
that
no, you
might
put words into my mouth.
Be amazing or cure cancer or something.
Yeah, I'm just going to kill it.
I'm going to kill it.
Vacuum
but
cleaner.
The guy that's proven himself to be a worthless shit
Lives.
By choking your wife.
Or your kid that could have been a cure cancer.
And your kid.
That could have cured cancer.
That could have cured cancer.
Yeah, could have, would have, should have. It's not going to happen. You know it.
Do you convict a man for punching your aborted fetus?
Oh, my.
I give him a high five.
What's an uppercut.
What's the context?
Whammy!
What's the context?
What's the contest?
And how far along? That's easy.
Hammer
two.
Throw.
Wow.
Can you high five that person?
For my child,
with,
yes.
With,
he gets punished.
With umbilical
killed?
Cord
no.
throwing babies?
Yes.
Wait.
Someone go get us a
fucking baby lasso. It's all the right. dead baby lasso.
It sounds like a great sounds like a great game here. We should get some
aborted.
All right, listen.
We're in some after hours right now.
Guilt trip myself.
I just like to, if you can shout out Charlie Brown.
Warning.
Kevin Pratt. Thank you.
There it is, Charlie Brown.
That's me.
Yes, it is.
Apparently.
Oh,
where's
I guess
Charlie
it is.
Brown come from?
No clue.
It sounded like a work-related thing.
No, that wasn't anybody I work with.
Interesting. That's very interesting, then. So you didn't even recognize the voice?
No.
Oh, nice.
Sean's at a Red Wing game right now.
Sitting
in box seats. Yeah, I don't get the Charlie Brown reference, but hey, if you left that voicemail, you can call us back.
The numbers again are 585
and talk to me and tell me about Charlie Brown.
I will say this. You know, I was watching some of the coverage here. Saw some choppers overhead. Also, I think you saw a chopper last night, KP.
I did.
You called me at one in the morning.
Actually, it was like 12. It might have been the work chopper.
Yeah, I was going to say, that place chopper is really doing good to have a helicopter to come find you.
Apparently.
Do we have that there? I liked this video. It was kind of blurry, but you said that you could probably.
I could have probably threw a rock at it. It was that close.
Now, this is what I thought. What if you did throw a rock at it? Damn, this thing was in your yard.
Dude, it gets a little better.
Citizen, get to work.
Yeah.
Get to work
KP.
Now. Kevin! What if that came across the speakers? You'd be so pissed. Kevin! I just ran out of chopper.
Like, as you can see, the thing's just hovering.
And you said you had some woods behind your house?
Across the street.
Yeah, motherfuckers. Copter, helicopter, just been circling the house all night.
What, do you think you're famous? You're excited about it?
Ain't no damn UFO. It's a funky copter.
The funky copter. Here to take you to Funky Town. A.K.A. work.
Dude, just listen to the chopper, dude. It's that thing is close, and right now it sounds like. Right now it sounds like it's trying. It's like descending onto the neighborhood, like it's coming down.
Yeah, those blades are slowing down. It's hovering now. It's not moving.
Yeah. And I'm literally right there.
What's
on it,
buddy.
Hey, buddy, you're looking for me. You know what you should have done? Should have ran out into the woods. Just to see if the light followed you and start dancing.
They had no spotlight on anything. So it wasn't like... And the only thing I could think of is they might have been...
Thermal?
Yes, thermal hitting some area across the street where they were.
Can you see KP in like an old school fucking... O.J. Simpson chase where he's just running, hopping over fences like cops?
Stop! I can't. Look at this thing, dude. It's just there, dude.
Yeah, I don't know. Get to work. That's what they're saying.
Dude, you hear that chopper. That's not a chopper that's just passing by, dude. That thing is right there above me.
With no lights, they certainly have the thermal out. I mean, why else would they be so low?
Yes.
So let's just take presumptions. I'm guessing they were looking for the kid that did the gate shooting.
No,
they already had him
in
custody. This was last night at 11:30.
Looking for his buddies?
No.
You got any shitty neighbors?
my mom lives across the street, and that's kind of where they were hovering, was above across the street. There's about a 20-foot wooded area between my mom's apartment and then the condos they built on the canal there many years ago.
Yeah, I've ran through that field. And, tripping on acid, carrying a sign.
Sure. That says I'm on acid.
They had turn around or something, or dead end. I forget. It was one of those big yellow signs, and we were tripping really hard. And so he said, go get that sign. Said, good idea.
That sounds like a great idea.
I was a little fat kid jogging through muddy marsh carrying this big wobbly sign.
Was. Holy
but,
moly.
There's a bad element that rolls in that on that other side of the woods. I mean, the
in
cops
that condom?
Are condominiums that they built over there, or condo houses or whatever
condos.
They are. Yeah.
Gotcha.
And
just not condoms.
Condoms.
That's what caused the problem.
Yeah. There's a bad element that rolls around in those rubbles there.
There's been some people that have came through them woods from over there and like broke into cars and like stole cars, and the cops have been in and out of over there all the time. And
not
I did see
enough.
A cop yesterday around 6 o'clock driving through the neighborhood. And then that saw the copter. The thing was, I was in the house and I heard the copter come by. So I opened the door and I looked out because it was like so loud. And I'm like, why does it sound like they're landing in the front yard? So I look out and it was taking the normal path that like all the planes take that come by my neighborhood. You know, their descent, they would come like almost like follow the line of my street and then swing around up towards 390 to the airport. You know what I mean?
14607 threw a link in the chat to live video Baltimore protest if you want to check that out, see if it's worth putting up.
Sure. But and then the thing came back and then just was hovering for like a half hour. That like literally hovering, and then it would go maybe 100 yards and then turn around. I don't know. They had to have been, you know, looking for something.
Outfield says Ange rented it. Where are you, KP?
I know you're not at work.
Between Pineapple Jackson
his house, it keeps us going back and forth.
She actually was a little nervous about it, actually. She was like, because you know I pound that conspiracy theory crap into her head.
I thought he was going to say pussy.
Just end the show. She's a little nervous. They're probably coming to rescue her, because you know I pound that until we have babies.
Yeah. One time.
Oh, there's the premonition right there. There's a second one coming.
So she's like, what are they doing? Like, she was ready to hit the basement, grab the cases of water and the cases of food and some... Let's hit the basement.
You guys got some tuna cans and a deadbolt on the basement door?
I always tell her we would take the high ground if something like that ever happened, like, you know, anarchy.
Really? That'd be a first for you.
Yeah.
Taking the high ground.
But, dude, you go into a basement, you're stuck. How you getting out? There's one way in and one way out.
Yeah, but then they'll treat you like, what's his name, Eric Dorner or whatever. If you take the high ground, they can always burn you out.
Well, I'm saying I could at least jump out of a second-story window. I could... bash the ceiling in
because you crumpled your leg under your own weight on the ground floor. So
believe me, if I had to break a leg to get out,
I'd
I'm
take
doing
out the
it.
Garbage.
Yeah, I broke a leg taking
Sorry,
the garbage out.
I keep coming in for these great one-liner
yeah,
setups.
You're full of it tonight, buddy. Great
oh,
job you're doing.
Goodness.
I found the live stream there. It's not the one he sent us, but it is a live stream. It's the best I could do.
Yeah,
I've tried loading up that other page. It won't load
up. They're out here because they've been out here for years, really working the community, encouraging the youth. They say because, you know, that's what we have to do. We have to encourage the youth. And they say that's why they're out here today, because they know a lot of these kids. That was a group of men told me. They said, hey, we know a lot of these kids.
And that's your fault.
Why we're out here, because we want to be able to stop them and talk some sense into them if they could. And that's the whole point of all of this today. And that's why so many men want to take part in this.
Alrighty.
No, they just want free
the
shit.
The subway system. I want to mention real quickly an advisory just came out from MTA that due to the ongoing police activity, Metro Subway will only operate from Owings Mills to West Cold Spring stations until further
notice. Not even going into the area, dude.
Let me guess, that's the white neighborhood, right?
Operating only
sure.
From Owings Mills to West
they shut down Camden Yards tonight, Baltimore Orioles Stadium, which is only blocks from, I think, this area.
I think that's the first black fireman I've ever seen on the other screen here.
Virtually paralyzed.
Yeah, paralyzed. And next to you,
I'm not even kidding.
Image of these four fires that are still burning down in East Baltimore.
He was old, too.
I did hear from a former fire chief who says that...
Oh, they looted the bar and lounge.
Oh, dude, these guys are hitting everything.
From surrounding fire departments in Orlando County,
there is bottles of Henny popping off in the hood tonight of Baltimore.
Yeah, why pay $9 a shot, an overpriced shot at your local pub when you could go and yank the whole thing out?
You know, you have to believe that these fires are going to be brought under control.
Yeah, I can't wait to look on eBay for a new mixer tomorrow.
But also in the news, besides this big Baltimore thing, the NAACP president was arrested on cocaine distribution charges.
Yes, yes. This
What a fancy thing.
Yes, this guy actually, you know, he's the spokesperson at least, right? Is he the head of it or the spokesperson or what? Oh, look at the outfield. That reporter's an ignorant ass. There you go. Sending one to you at home.
Oh, here he is. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen. This is the... it's the president, right, Cheeks? Let's check our information.
Well, that's what I was about to
Thank
do.
Thank
right
you.
Now.
We don't need any more calls about our bad reporting.
Oh, Jesus. How about our bad show? We can get a couple of those in.
Yeah, and it down to 20 minutes. They're just throwing a bunch more commercials.
Good,
intern
good
asks
call.
For.
Look at
how
many phone calls we missed because that light is there and he's looking at it. People want to tell us live we suck and we're just ignoring them.
If you're watching and you want to call and tell us how bad we are or what a great job we're doing, you can also do that. We won't be mad. Really, Tarl? You're just going to smack that thing off your mic for the next 20 minutes?
Yes.
Yep, apparently you are. Let's get a mute on that kid.
He is the president.
Of what? The
NAACP president.
All right, president.
And he sold 1 gram of cocaine to a confidential informant.
What? If you're the president of the NAACP, why do you have to sell dope? What really? I mean, isn't there money in that for that guy?
See, Tony brought up a good point back in the day, our buddy Uni. When Michael Vick got busted for that dog fighting ring, he's like, wow, I make millions of dollars. Let's see how I can make a couple thousand.
Well,
it's like
they were making more money than that off the dog. They were it was hundreds of thousands that were being made on them dog fighting. It was big time players that were putting money on that.
But is that just really the
he had just gotten a contract for $100 million.
He was the highest paid player at that point.
Do you know that he had a 6-year $100 million contract when he was with the Falcons? He got in all that trouble, went to jail, got humiliated, annihilated by the press, by everyone around him, came out of jail after doing his time, got signed by the Philadelphia Eagles as a backup, played 5 or 6 games, I think, did very well, and received another $100 million contract.
That's how good he was.
It,
what did you think of him as a QB?
He was a better Randall Cunningham. If you remember Randall Cunningham.
Yeah, I do.
Randall Cunningham could run around
a Vikings fan.
A lunatic. Yeah, should have won the Super Bowl that year. But Michael Vick just wasn't a great passer. He became a better passer later on. But back then, dude, he just run right by you. You couldn't stop him. Oh, you're talking about that game when he ran like a 50-yard run in overtime to beat the Vikings?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what I'm talking about.
Well, you know, talking about people that are great, I mean, Timothy Wade Miles, this guy that got arrested, he's not so great because this is the third time.
He's been busted selling dope?
In monitored buys.
Wow.
So that means this
third
is the third
undercover?
Time.
Third undercover?
Yes.
Where is this?
It is Delaware County.
Do they have a 3 strikes law?
Doesn't say.
Ugh.
Hang on, I'll find out.
You know what? I think it's time for...
It's the lightning round!
The lightning round, ladies and gentlemen. We got plenty to talk about. And only 9 minutes. Here we are. Obama's email hacked by the Russians.
His unclassified emails.
Yes. That means every time he, you know, it wasn't about... It was like basically everything that Hillary erased. But the Russians got his. Yeah. How is that possible?
Hackers, man. Goose must have been on the job.
Oh, Goose, you son of a bitch.
How long do you think before somebody comes knocking on Goose's fucking front door?
I think it'll be a while. I really do. I hope it'll be a while. I mean, let me see here. Walmart. The Walmart shut down 6 stores simultaneously over the week.
Yep. And people were really like, what the hell's going on?
Well, yeah. They 6 stores shut down simultaneously for plumbing problems that could take up to 6 months. It takes 2 months to build a Walmart, but 6 months to fix this plumbing in 6 different Walmarts. All, dude, it looked like FEMA camp spread. They weren't even in the same town or anything. It was all over the country.
Yep.
Military trucks were rolling in.
And what did you hear about this?
Well, the operation was called Jade Helm, or at least what they think it is.
I think they're getting ready for that operation. I don't think that operation has actually taken place. I think it's supposed to take place in June or July, where I think they're it's a simulation or whatever they call it of the state of Texas is actually going to be considered an enemy state in this operation.
All right.
And people, I just saw something on Facebook. People, a link someone shared that hundreds and hundreds and thousands of people in Texas are trying to fight to have this operation shut down.
Sure. Well, they think that Texas is going to be one of the places, you know, they're already trying to secede.
Texas has already tried to succeed, and it's the largest population of gun owners.
So look at this. This is the map right here. Let me see if I could send this over to you, this link. But basically, there's California, Oklahoma, Louisiana, Texas, and Florida. Those aren't even close to each other.
No. So it was a pretty big stretch of plumbing problems.
Yeah, really. That's
from Florida to California,
pipe.
Yeah.
I'm throwing this to the underground page if you want to look at it there, Sweet Tea. They're not answering any questions. They're saying that it's basically just a test, like you said, to combat an enemy state, if you will.
Well, I think the operation has more to do with civil uprising.
Sure.
And it's their response to a civil uprising, and I'm assuming they're thinking Texas is going to be a problem if that happens.
Well, Texas has always said fuck you about this type of thing.
Sure.
But they're so spread out, it just makes me believe that it's not all in Texas. It's literally, all over the southern part of the
country.
Yep. I don't know. Walmart.
People were saying that this operation is definitely seems like a ruse to like something bigger. Just obviously, everyone's eyes are usually shut to things like this.
I don't know. The outfield's commenting that Walmart, you want $15 per hour? Fuck you. Do you think it was a Walmart retaliation to the wages?
No.
Demands?
The employees got 5 or 6 hours notification that they were out of work. And that was it.
I've actually had a place that I've left. I got a phone call in the middle of the night. They locked the doors.
Sure.
You got tomorrow off. Forever.
I got a call. I didn't get a call.
Yeah,
you got it.
You got 0 minutes notice. They came right out to the parking lot and told you had the day off.
No, I'm talking. Yes.
Kevin!
Go to work. But, I've been told face-to-face, hey, buddy, you got 72 hours, which is more than you got, Tarno.
I was actually with a kid, and I went to...
Yeah, we know you were.
Talking to the fucking light up there.
We know you were with a kid once.
I was with him, and he was walking up to his job. We went to the same place. I gave him a ride, dropped him off, go work at his job. Walk around the corner, and his whole building was just boarded up. Just boarded up.
Well,
yeah,
fly by night. All right, let's hurry up. First person's going to be here at 8. Let's close it down.
All right, buddy, let's go smoke a blunt instead.
Here you go, Rhode Island, Motel 6. Now offering their guest list every night to the police department.
Really?
Yes.
Must be a lot of hookers.
They're talking about that the motel has a lot of seedy individuals, many of them possibly criminals. So
Jesus.
They're handing over their list. So if you want to go and hang out with a chick in a hotel room, but you have a warrant, you're going to get arrested at the Motel 6.
Could you imagine if they handed out the 490s list?
Oh, Jesus. Yeah, that, you know what? Nobody's even there for a whole night.
How is that place even still open?
They're renting by the hour.
Yeah. You could probably rent by the minute.
You're probably, well, it, nobody's
all
renting by the
minute.
All
I'm going to need is 15 minutes.
Well, we got to charge you for the half hour, sir. Sorry.
All right. I guess I'm going to have to beat her twice.
You're probably not wrong.
No, I'm not.
Still in.
It's the lightning round.
The Nepal earthquake.
Wow.
4,000 people dead. Mm. They were saying for decades, experts said there was going to be some kind of quake there. And now 4,000 people are dead, including a top Google executive. One guy that was there from Rochester is alive. I don't know why he was there. Probably everybody's just going for the adventure
or
whatever.
He's got quite a tan, though.
What do you got here,
T? There's no audio on this, but this is the actual earthquake happening.
Oh, let's take a peek.
Oh, I'm sorry, Cheeks. I didn't see you go to that joke already.
Okay. Yeah, no, I was going to say, check out this picture I got. This is part of the devastation.
Cheeks wants you guys to give names to this guy that got squashed up here.
Flanny.
Old Mo Sizzalock.
let's take a look at the this is the video here. Is that what this is?
Yeah.
When you get it. All right, there we go.
Cheeks killed his own joke.
Sure did.
Anyways, yeah, watch this shit happen. Look at those bushes are fucking flailing.
I wish you would have had this kind of help over the weekend. You had to yank them all out with your truck. And somebody else driving the truck.
Did you not drive it?
No, it's on my property. I think it's legal for me to drive it.
No, it's not.
I feel like it's not.
It's probably not legal for me to own it.
Next time you do that, I'm just going to fucking run up, throw a bunch of booze on you, and then call the cops.
I like that.
That's funny.
I like that option.
That's the best thing you've said all day.
They pull up, and there's Tarno drinking and driving in his driveway.
U.S. drone strike.
Look, here's some pictures. Look at some pictures of this fucking earthquake that happened. This guy literally got chopped in half.
Shaking out of his shoes.
Could you say he's half the man he used to be?
Yeah, oh, Jesus.
There's somebody's house.
Yeah, or that's Spider-Man.
What's that, the Insomniac
right
studio?
no, actually, this is the guy that broke his ankle in the stabbing picture of Baltimore there. That's what happened, man.
He
these
said,
guys
screw
got
it,
screwed.
I'm getting out of Baltimore. I'm going to Nepal.
Oh, my God. Yeah, these guys got, there's nothing but rubble, man. If everything
like
shook around you.
4,000 people are dead. That's a lot of fucking people.
How that's more than everybody you know.
Yeah, right?
Times 10.
Yeah, that too.
Ah.
U.S. drone strike kills American and Italian hostages.
Way to go. Because those things keep fucking going so well for the country.
Oh, yeah. Nobody's pissed at us. There's not going to be any retaliation.
Nobody
about
cares
it.
About the drone strikes that just keep demolishing places and killing innocent people.
I can't wait till you light your mic screen on fire, Tarno. It's going to happen.
I was hoping your beard.
Jamaica plants first legal marijuana plant.
Really?
Yeah. It's
the government?
No, I don't know if it was the government or not. I don't have that type of research time. Are you kidding me?
I mean, we don't hear it under the skin.
I just look at a headline.
We just wing it.
Yeah, that's all. But I noticed that, you know, Bob Marley brought up the culture history of everybody in Jamaica's high or whatever. And I've heard a lot of stories about, you know, people go to Jamaica.
Have you been talking lately?
No. Well, yes.
You can now talk to the dead, huh, Emerson?
Yeah, I have been for a long time. It's called My Audience.
Yes.
The first legal plant was planted on the University of the West Indies Mona campus on Monday.
That's
Mona,
good.
Huh?
Yep. University of the West Indies Mona campus.
Yeah, I think that's all right. You know, but that's what you hear. People that go to Jamaica, there's some guy on the beach that rolls up with a bunch of bags and sells you some. I don't know if it was highly criminalized, but it was still illegal. But now, not illegal.
Down by the beach.
Ah, Cheeks, give a picture of this. Look how happy everybody is. Look at this. Is anybody burnt? Oh, I'm sorry, Cheeks, you can't see that. It's on the computer. I'll find it.
Wow,
damn it.
You guys are working in such harmony back
Everybody's
there.
So happy in this picture.
Wow, jeez. Except
is that what
us.
Weed does?
They do look quite happy.
All right, move on.
Yeah, whatever. That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for watching UnderTheSkin.tv's Monday Medicine here on the website. I also encourage you to check us out this Thursday on WBGT-TV, Time Warner Channel 18, Thursday late night, 12:30 a.m.
Technically Friday.
And you're going to check us out, half-hour format. We'll reduce this to the best half hour. You'll enjoy it or not. And then you'll bitch about us and call us racists on Craigslist. Because that's apparently what happens every fucking week.
Yeah, Craigslist has been hammering us lately, dude. Apparently we're the ones that are putting all the racist posts on Craigslist.
I don't have time for that.
Which we are not.
Shit.
Just want to put that out there. We are not Tom Shelley, and we do not condone racism.
I love that you had to put that out there. You called me so worried last night. You're like, dude, there's a chopper above my house. I think it's Craig.
And he's got a list.
Yes. A list of all the bad things you've said on this show. It's quite extensive. You want to say anything else?
Das svidaniya.
All right. Well, there you go. That's most sense you've made tonight, strangely enough.
Yep.
Everybody, we appreciate the views. We have the podcast.
Pod love?
The pod love.
We got potluck.
The potluck dinner. Come on down to the Gates Pub.
I vote to change Podfest to pod love.
The pod love?
The pod love.
I think
our own?
We should start our own.
Jesus. And, should we really?
And, no. No one loves us.
And steal all the podcasts to come do ours.
I doubt it'll happen. And it'll be on our back when nobody shows up.
Yeah, the motivation on the show. Fuck.
Oh, goodness. All right. Well, thank you, KP.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Sweet Tea.
Can you take us out with a song, Emerson?
Oh, I sure can.
Let's do it.
Thank you, Kevin, for calling him out on that.
Let me crank it up.
That is the smallest V guitar I've ever seen.
It's a little spaceship.
Fits you well.
Kevin. Kevin, go to work. Kevin, go to work.
Just show up tomorrow. Just show up. I know you got the day off, but just show up and say, I'm trying to make up.
Sorry. Yeah, just go there, sweep.
Work for free.
Just sweep, whatever.
I actually stopped by the restaurant because my boss was unloading some product into the restaurant.
Oh, boy. NWACP and AACP. WA.
It's what's in the pancakes.
Kevin! Kevin!
All right, everybody. We will see you next week.
Take us out, Emerson.
Bye.
Kevin!
I'll be at work. You've just tuned in to the Monday Medicine, the weekly debacle that takes place every week here on Under the Skin. If you'd like to call in after hours, fuck off and leave a message. If not, we'll see you next week.
Well, this is Mark O'Neill. You're watching UnderTheSkin.tv.